Let's head on back out to Lake Oswego and the crazy Three Rivers League. Dirk Knutson, NorthwestPrepReport.com. Been there, and we appreciate the updates there with Oregon City and Lake Oswego as we get set for the playoffs. We know a couple of teams that clinched their spots about 3 weeks ago. Number one Central Catholic, number two Tigard, and they will have a week off and see how the brackets play out. But for a couple of guys, a big week with some commitments and some more offers coming in, Dirk.
Yes, Swag. It's been pretty quiet out on the offer front, and there may be some causality for that. But we did see here within the last week, Manu Rasmussen, who, you know, we've talked about him. Everyone loves the kid, 6 foot 180, plays about four or five positions for these guys. He's right at that 1,000-yard mark going into tonight, having not seen his numbers. But he has been offered by Eastern Washington. He did the visitation, went up there, took part of an Eagles game, stood on the red turf, the whole deal. Came home with an offer, you know, tells us in our article here, you'll see it really was impressed. Saw Kendrick Bourne from Milwaukee playing, getting a touchdown, getting quality time. Guys like Cooper Kupp, who was from AC Davis up in the Yakima area, the kid who beat Oregon State, saw him play and being a dominant player in his second year as a starter. So Mono's light went on that, hey, this could be a great fit because he certainly could play early there next year and be another gem that those guys, you know, stole. For him, the question is, would Oregon State maybe offer? Because it sounds like he really loves Oregon State. And boy, I could see him in the black and orange with on the defensive side. He's just terrific that way. And then you talked about Central Catholic having a commit. Aiden Wilder, the much-heralded playmaker, quarterback, do-it-all, leader of that offense, did have the Portland State offer. I think as a smart kid, realizing things are a little dry out there on the offer front, especially for quarterbacks this year. So Aiden locked down his position as a pistol quarterback of the future for Nigel Burton. Would the kid, you know, pull up on that if he had an opportunity to go to a Boise State or a Wyoming or somewhere? I get the sense that he's open like any kid is, but he's very comfortable staying in Portland and playing for the Vikings. Seems pretty happy about that.
Dirk Knutson here, our man on the recruiting trail for NorthwestPrepReport.com and Rivals as we roll on here, wrapping up the regular season on the Les Schwab postgame scoreboard show. You know, you talked about the commitments or the offers not coming fast and furious here in the West like we've seen the past couple of years. Is the talent pool not as rich as it was the last few years, or is there something else going on with the universities?
No, I think the talent pool's there, right? We've tracked that the last few years where we saw this progression from, you know, a handful of guys getting D1 type of action back in the 2005-06 era when we started last year, closed out with 36 D1 and D1 2A guys from Oregon. I don't think we're going to hit that number this year, but we may come close, but we're going to need a late surge from these colleges. And the word on the recruiting front, and this comes a little bit from the conversations that we have had with coaches, which are fairly limited because we try to stay in a neutral role here. So talking to Eric Jackson, former Portland State coach, who now has a recruiting service, academic-based recruiting service for charges about $500 a year, great guy. He's one of about three recruiting types that we know who run that type of service who said in their efforts to call all over the West Coast, they're hearing, we're full. We're full. We have nothing to give. And some of that's just the way gray shirts, red shirts, walk-ons have fallen into place. So it is extremely tight out there for fans wondering why aren't these kids getting offers. It's partly because apparently there's just not those offers to give. We will see some teams holding on to that last couple of offers that are still waiting to make that decision, you know, on a guy like Manu Rasmussen or Nick Underwood or any number of these guys we've been talking about right there. They're still kind of waiting to see, do we give that offer out? So kids would be wise, parents would be wise to spread their search out, to really, really look beyond just the Pacific Northwest. California is not a great option because they don't scholarship too many Oregon kids, but they'll look into the Mountain West states, jump over the Rockies, and start doing your research on what's out there because there's a lot of opportunities.
Well, and we got a couple of stud receivers, big, tall, lanky, athletic, with good hands in Mitch Herbert from Sheldon and J.R. McLaughlin out there at Lakeridge. What are the odds these guys might see some offers coming in late in the recruiting season?
Well, Mitch Herbert at Sheldon is right at that 500-yard mark, and what he's doing is he's catching for 22 yards a catch, 6'4", 200-pounder. So his production's been great. I think he's had 22 catches this year as well. So I think that Sheldon Sheldon's got the younger Strom kid and a number of other guys in the mix. They're back to spraying the ball all over the place under Kuhn down there, who has turned into a good passing QB. Herbert has Air Force, has Portland State. When you watch his film, which he did update, we put that up, it's easy to see, you know, why he could play up and have more options. And I think he will. I think he'll be a guy that, while he's not probably an Oregon Duck, I do think he's a, you know, he's got options there out of those Mountain West states. Now, whether Oregon State or somebody could grab him, I think they probably could. But he's a great kid, 4.0 student. And then McLaughlin was a lesser known of the two in the offseason, but was known for having a great year last year. This kid is right at 1,000 yards, leads of the state, and Dungy and he are just the 1-2 punch. And I could get real excited if I was a coach about recruiting this young guy, because he does have that same set of skills. So those two guys, along with Jordan Morgan from Southridge, Jerae Kendall at Lincoln having a nice year. There's a number of receivers. Again, remember, these receivers are competing with kids typically out of bigger states like Texas and California, who probably have that extra step of speed. It tends to be the great separator in recruitment of receivers. Right?
Indeed, you can read all about them, northwestprepreport.com, as well as learn a little bit more about some of the key cogs for these Westview Wildcats we saw here tonight and their resurgence and the great season that they've had. Quarterback Austin Brisby going to be one of those big names his senior season next year. But first, they got some playoff action to worry about. So does Lakeridge and Sheldon and all these teams. Should be a wild, wild playoff season at the 6A level. And we look forward to starting that with next week's play-in games. Dirk, as always, we appreciate it. Thanks so much, and we'll talk to you next Friday.
Thank you too, Swag.